Thank you. I met a very senior, respected Sinhala politician a day or two ago. He made a pertinent observation. He said my speeches were not vituperative nor abusive. He advised never lose sight of the need to be objective. I truly value this advice. I hate none, but I love truth. I have come to conclusions about our past after studying certain historical facts. If my conclusions are wrong, others must point out the shortcomings in my conclusions. Instead, to get upset and abuse me and invite me for public debate does not make truth a falsehood or vice versa. If need be, Honorable Speaker, let a commission be appointed consisting of top Sinhala, Tamil, Muslim, and international historians well-versed in South Asian history to report on our heritage and history. The historians must be internationally recognized persons. I, for my part, would like to tender a note to your honor to be included in the Hansard, which speaks of the antiquity of the Tamil language and the Tamil society in Sri Lanka, prepared by a respected emeritus professor of history, Professor Padmanathan. To my friend, Mr. Udaya Gamanpilla, I like to tell him that during the past 10 or 15 years, all his historical references have become outdated. Let him learn his history again and then come back. An honorable member from Colombo named me personally yesterday and referred to certain matters against me. I may be given a few minutes to, in addition to my quota, if possible, to reply him. Finally, he said that I had forbidden Sinhalese and Muslims entering North when I was chief minister. Truly, I must be a demon to have said so when my children have both married Sinhalese. Mr. Speaker, I do not indulge in such vituperative racial exercises. I would like to see any video or audio report of such speech, if there be one, to explain to the honorable member. But certainly, I may have said that it was wrong to bring outsiders to set them up in the Mahabali colonization schemes, contrary to international law principles, which expects the local people to be given priority. Honorable member asked if I had given blood to patients and went on to say only military members give blood to blood banks. Honorable member should realize the people of the North had given blood to blood banks prior to the army coming to the North as well as afterwards. They are aware that all blood fall within four categories. They do not believe, as some do, that some are born with blue blood. The honorable member asked me naively, what of the Tamils of the other part of the country constituting almost 60% if federalism is granted to the North and East? Honorable member should remember that we do not ask for separation. Federalism is unity in diversity. Nothing adverse will happen to the Tamils elsewhere unless the honorable member sets up his gundas to attack them for no fault of theirs. There were certain other matters he had said, but I have forgotten them. When the occasion arises, I shall deal with them. I think most humbly, Mr. Honorable Speaker, and others among this august assembly of men and women who stood by democracy and fair play without being drawn into the crude racial vituperative net that a few parliamentarians were trying to lay. I must thank the Secretary General for being very professional and forthright in dealing with this same member's outburst at our training session. Let me now come to the matter in hand. As a representative—
Honorable Member, you have 2 minutes left.
As a representative of the Tamils, I find nothing significant to comment on this midterm vote on account. No government has so far rendered any significant help to pull out our war-affected people from their penury-stricken indigent circumstances. They are also not interested in granting economic powers to the periphery to enable them to look after themselves. You would remember the Chief Minister's Fund was refused to our province during the time of both governments. Hence, I deem it necessary to stress on this occasion the urgent need to solve the political question of the Tamils West, which is basic to the amelioration of the conditions of our affected people. We are fortunate that the Honorable Prime Minister, Mr. Mahinda Rajapaksa, has obtained 2/3 majority in this parliament. He has been showered a golden opportunity to usher in a peaceful and prosperous country by granting what I call ekathism as opposed to ekiaism. This country could be transformed into a veritable heaven on earth despite its 10 trillion international debt. A form of unionism, which in fact is federalism, is the panacea for our national question. Unity is diversity. It would be stupid, sir, to run away from problems by saying such problems do not exist, akin to the ostrich, which lowers its head in sand, hoping to find safe haven. Let us face the national question together. Let us not hand it over to the next generation. To win a war is easy, but to bring about peace is extremely difficult. But it is peace that could usher in permanent victory. It is this realization that made King Asoka to embrace Buddhism. The new utterance, I like to ask a question, Honorable Sir. Why did we fight for independence from the British? We were peaceful and prosperous. In fact, Lee Kuan Yew saw that he would make Singapore another Ceylon. Such was the peace and prosperity of our country under the British. But we still wanted independence. Why? It was our desire to resurrect our identity by language, heritage, and culture that made us want ourselves to be freed from the domination by the British. Many of you would be surprised.
Honorable Member, your time is up. Please wind up.
Just 1 minute. Many of you would be surprised to hear, especially in Colombo, that the Tamils of the North and East are now exactly in the same predicament that we were before independence. Our people live under Sinhala Buddhist dominance today. Though we in Ceylon did not have to take up arms to get freedom from the British, since Gandhiji in India obtained it for us in an oblique way, our youth had to take up to arms to ward off the Sinhala Buddhist governmental dominance over us. I am more than anyone else aware acutely of our political and social limitations in the North and East. I do not wish to...
Please wind up.
May I say, sir, that my note plus the other historical note that I...
Yes, please table it.
And hand it over to the Hansard. Thank you.